Finally, guys, the game changer is here. YOLOv8 is now released, and apart from its accuracy, it is very easy to use. That means you watching this video can also use YOLOv8 because it's the simplified version of all the YOLO models. That's why in this video, I'm going to take you through how to run object detection on the items in the COCO dataset. So I will teach you step by step and also give you the link to this notebook we'll be using in this tutorial for free, so that you can also work with it, run your own custom models at any time. So this is all going to be easy because we are going to use Google Colab, which will give us access to free GPUs. We'll first test this model on images, then we'll run it on a video file to see how accurate it detects vehicles on the street. So I know you are very excited about this, so let's get right into it because it's YOLO time and we have to only look once. Alright guys, so the first thing I'll go ahead and do is to fire up my Chrome browser. So you can use Google Chrome or use any browser of your choice. I prefer using Google Chrome. So we'll be doing this in Google Colab since we are going to be giving free GPU from Google. So I'll just click on Google Colab. I have it here. If you don't, you just search Google Colab. You follow the instruction. It's very simple. You just search Google Colab and that's it. So I'll click on Google Colab and this will load. Okay, so this is what I'm presented with. And since I've created a notebook which will be going through, I'll hit upload. And I'll make sure the link to this notebook will be in the description for you guys so you can work with. So you choose the file and I have it on my desktop. So I'll just scroll down and here is it. I have to just open it. So this will load and then you can see we got a success message, so it will open the web browser and it will open our notebook for us. So in short, these are the few steps we'll be going through to run our detection. So we have to first mount our Google Drive and we just execute this line of code to mount it simply. So from Google Colab, we import drive and then we use the function drive.mount, and in here we provide the path we want to mount this drive at. So you can choose any directory here. This comes by default from Google Colab content /drive. So run this cell and it will execute and our drive will mount. So you can say manage session. So we already have this running, so we'll terminate it or we'll terminate other sessions. Okay, so we can close this now and rerun the script. So this actually takes some time depending on your internet speed. And this will pop up to ask for your permission to your Google Drive. So you just have to hit connect to Google Drive. It will pop up for you to choose your account. So I've chosen my account and in here I have to allow, then my Google Drive will be successfully mounted. So it's loading and I'm sure we'll get a success message after this. Okay, so now drive is mounted at this directory. So we have our drive being mounted. The next step is to check whether we are having GPU access. So for that, you have to just write NVIDIA-SMI to check whether or not you are having GPU access. So you just run this block and boom, you can see we are having GPU access. So we are having it here, but we have no process running on that access yet. Okay, so now we have to check our directory. So check your directory. I've commented this up so that you guys can follow suitably. So we'll run this cell and you can see our current directory we are working now is /content, which is correct. So we import OS and we create a variable here called directory and we use os.getCurrentWorkingDirectory function to get it. After that, we are just printing directories to get it here. Okay, so that's nice. And now let's come to the fun part. If you have been using YOLO for a while, you know you don't have the pip command in YOLO, but for now in the YOLO v8 or version 8, we have the pip command, which is a game changer. You can directly clone the repository using git clone, but I think this is easy now, and they've included this so that it will make our life turn easier. So you just click on this cell and you install Ultralytics, and your YOLO model will be installed for you. So we just run this cell. It will take some time to load, and it will download all the files and our requirements for us. And now what you can see is that we are not having any error messages. And since we are not interested in these drop downs, we can just click here to get rid of them. And now the next step now is to import our YOLO module we've installed. So we are importing YOLO, and we are also importing IPython. We are importing display from IPython to display our images we'll be using in this case. So I'll run this cell to directly import YOLO. Okay, so no errors. Now we've imported it, and straight away we can go ahead and run some tests. So in my opinion, this version of YOLO has simplified most of your works for you. It's just straightforward and it's easy to run. So to run a test on an image, this image must be in the Cocoa dataset, and here is the Cocoa dataset. These are the things contained in the Cocoa dataset. We'll also learn later on how to train our custom YOLO v8 module, but for now we are going to run our test on the Cocoa dataset. So the image we provide to this model must include things like snowboard, sportsboard, kite, and so on. So in the Cocoa dataset we have about 80 different items in it. We have motorbikes, aeroplane, bus, train, truck, and we have a lot of common stuff in it. So our image must contain these stuffs. Other than that, we have to train our custom detector, which we'll be looking in future videos. Okay, so how do we run a test then? We have two ways now, and we have one game changer way, I call it. We can use the Python SDK and also the old way of running YOLO. So you just write YOLO, then the task is to detect. So now we have to use the model to detect something on our image. So we specify the task to be detect. Then the mode is that we want to predict something. So we want to predict whatever is on our image. Then we have to use the particular model version we want. So we are using YOLO v8n.pt. We have many versions of YOLO v8 model, so you can choose any of them and test them out to see their efficiency. Then we specify our confidence. Then the important thing is the source, which in this case the source of our image we want to run the test on. So when I open here, we can go to our drive. Then in our drive we'll open this, and you can see we have image here of a car. So I'll open this image up, and this is the image we are going to run the test on. So we have 15 cars here in this image, and when we run this test, we expect that the model should be able to draw bounding boxes across each car and also give us information about how many cars. We'll be doing this on a video too. So you can see a video file here, losangeles.mp4, which is cars moving on the street of Los Angeles. We'll run a detection on it too as well, but let's get started with the car. So I'll close this up, and then I'll close this up too. Okay, so this is the directory where our image is. In case you want to get the directory, you just click here and just copy the path, then you paste it there to get your directory easily. So we'll run this cell now. And you can see it's just loading the module to load our image and then predict whatever it has seen in that image. Okay, so our run is over, and you can see the speed it has used and whatever it has found in the image, you can see it here. So this is the shape of our image, 448 by 640, and it has found 15 cars in the image. Wow, this model is damn accurate. So exactly what I counted before, the cars in the image is 15, and it has found the total number of these cars in this case. But what we need is to see our result, which is saved at runs /detect/predict. So this is where our model is saved, and we can assess that with the following lines of code. So when we run this, we can assess our model. So it is at run, detect, then predict. So we just write predict, and then the name of your image you want to assess, you put it here as the. So I'll run this cell now and we'll see whatever we are able to detect. So boom, you can see we have the detection on our cars now, and you can see it has detected each and every car. So we can't see the cars at the back, but the detection is correct because we are able to tell how many cars we have detected here, which is accurate in this case. Okay, this newer version of YOLO comes with another way of running your prediction on images or videos, which is by creating an instance of your model. So here we say model is equal to YOLO, then we specify our directory we are using, then we specify the type of model we want to use, which is the same type we chose here as YOLOv8m.pt. So you just specify that, and then what you do is you give this model the source of your image using model.predict, because you've went ahead and created a model instance here. Then we specify the source as the directory to our image, and we also give it the confidence as 0.25, just as what we use at the top here. So we can run this one to check whether it works. And I love this second option because you just create an instance, just like normal Python program. So we are getting an error here saying directory is not defined. Let's check at the top. Okay, so let's run this cell again. Okay, now we can come back and run it again for our directory to be loaded. Okay, so now we have no errors, and you can see we got the same information here, 15 cars. So it has detected 15 cars in our image, which is very accurate again. But here, one information we are lacking here is that it's not giving us the directory to where our image is saved, but it's the same directory we've used at the top here to be saved in the same directory. So we can run the same line of code here to get our detection. So you can see we have the same thing. So these are two different ways of running detections and getting your output, but I always prefer the second one using the Python SDK because it's very easy for me. In this case, you just write model and create instance of your model and give it the type of model you want to use. Then after that, you save it in result, then you predict, you give it a source. Other than that, you have to write this long YOLO tags, mode, and all the other stuffs. Okay, so this is how we can run a test on an image. We will now look at how we can also run tests on a video file, right? But before that, I can show you where you will get these images saved. Let's close up. So you go to runs, and then from runs, you go to detect, then here is where your prediction is saved. So in case you want to download this, you can just go ahead and download it, and it will just get downloaded for you. You can open this app. So let's open this, and you can see this is our image with the detections on it. So that's how you can download this image and also save it for later use, or post it with your friends to have fun with it. Okay, let's close this up. Let's also close this. Now the next step is to run a prediction on a video, so on a video file. So let's see how you can do that. So the only difference here is to give it the video directory instead of the image directory. So we'll come here, and since we have our video file in our drive, we open our drive, and then we copy the path of the video here and paste it at where we want it. So just paste the path in here to the video, and then we'll execute this file. So you go through all the video frames and try to detect whatever it has seen, and then after that to save your video file for you. So this takes some time depending on the length of your video. Okay, so the result is saved to RAM detect slash predict 2. So it's saving another file, and we can go ahead and search for that file. So we'll download this video results, because I think Google Colab is awful in playing videos. So we'll go ahead and just download this and play it using our computer media player. So it's in Predict 2. And I'll just click here and download. So this will take some time because the video file is a little bit big. So it will take some time to download. And after downloading, it will be in your downloads folder. Alright guys, so for a while now, our video is finally downloaded. So I'll just open it and play straight away. And you can see how well it's detecting. So it's detecting, and it's also putting in the confidence on them. So this is just playing over and over. It's a short video. And you can see how well this model is working. So I think overall this version of YOLO is very good, and it's very accurate, it's very fast, and most of all it's very easy to use. It's very friendly in this case than the older versions of YOLO. So let me have your thoughts about this version of YOLO in the comment section. For me, all I can say is that it works very fast, it's very easy to use. Its accuracy is at its peak. So I'll close this app, and once again I'll put this notebook in the description. So the link to it will be in the description, so that you can download and go through, test this with your custom videos, images, and make sure these images are part of the COCO dataset, or the objects in your image are part of the COCO dataset. So thanks for tuning in guys. If you find this interesting, kindly subscribe and share with your friends, so that we build a learning community together. Once again, thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.